Welcome to Frequent Traveler TV. Today we are here in the Finnair headquarters in Helsinki and we are interviewing for you Pekka Antila. Who is Pekka Antila? Pekka Antila is the head of loyalty of Finnair. He has a 20 years track record in the industry and I have to read it. Number one is he has been working in development, in management and in delivery of consumer products and services. Very important is that his studies are in behavioral sciences. So for us as Finnair Plus members, he wants, of course, always to anticipate what we are doing. And we are now interviewing him for you with the questions, especially about the Finnair Plus changes. What does it mean for us? And yeah, your questions will be answered. So let us go. Welcome to the terrace of Finnair headquarters here in Helsinki. You see in the back, of course, the airport and next to me, Pekka Antila, the head of loyalty of Finnair. First of all, of course, thank you for having us. We are bringing our questions to you that you can answer the questions the community has and that we have, of course, as Finnair Plus members with the changes. Do you want to tell us something about the changes which are coming?
Absolutely. But first, thanks, Lars, for having me, and thanks for coming here. At the very beginning, I'm sure that there will be many Finnair Plus members watching this video. I know many of you fly a lot with Finnair, many of you care a lot about Finnair, and I want to say thank you for that. And thanks also for the feedback that we have got, and thanks for your understanding while we implement the changes that we are implementing, and what those changes are. So with Finnair Plus, we have changes in three areas. First, changes related to benefits that relate to baggages. We have also introduced new prices for Finnair Classic Award flights and Travel Class upgrades. And we have introduced whole new benefits for Finnair Visa credit card holders.
Then you have even a new ticket, which is called the Superlight ticket. Why did you change the name? What does it mean for us as Platinum, Silver, Gold, and Lumo members? I call, of course, myself first as a Platinum, sorry.
So it's true. So as part of our product offering renewal, we introduced a new Economy Superlight ticket. That is a new ticket type for journeys within Europe. And with that ticket type, you get a small bag that you can place under the seat in front of you. Then if you are Finnair Plus Silver member, Gold, Platinum, Platinum Luma member, or you have One World status and you travel with Superlight ticket, you can carry one complimentary carry-on baggage with you on board to the cabin.
The weights for the cabin and the sizes, did they change?
Weight and size for the cabin bag has not changed. So for the economic cabin, the weight limit is 8 kilograms and for business it's 10 kilograms.
So all the same, the sizes, no change. We can just go to the airport like we used to be. Everybody is used to it. So
no change for the weight or size. There is change for the pieces.
One change which is felt by the people is the change in business class, that you have only one piece of luggage allowance and that it dropped from 32 kilograms to 23 kilograms. What are the reasons for that?
Well, first, it's probably good to mention that tier members, Gold members, Platinum members, and Platinum Luma members continue having their extra checked bag as a benefit. So that doesn't go anywhere.
But it's still 32 kilograms in the old system and 23 in the new system.
So if you start with tier benefits. So with the new baggage, practices and policies, Finnair Plus Gold members, Platinum members and Luma members continue having their extra check bag as their benefit. So extra checked bag of 23 kilograms. And if the bag does not fit to the standard size or standard weight, there will be a fee for that.
But sports luggage counts as your free luggage as well, if it's in the sizes, correct?
If the sport equipment does not weigh more than 23 kilograms or does not exceed the standard size, it can be carried as a bag.
One question I, of course, forgot to ask you in the beginning is, why did you implement these changes now? Because the aviation industry had a very tough 3 years. And what made you choose the 15th of June?
Right. So as an airline, Finnair, we have completed now 3 consecutive profitable quarters. But before that, we had 10 loss-making quarters. That's, of course, because of the pandemic. That's because of the closure of Russian airspace, which puts Finnair to a bit different position than many other airlines. The changes that we are implementing to Finnair Plus program, they are part of our strategy implementation. And now as we made some changes to our product offering, like introduced a new ticket type, we felt that it's the right thing to announce the changes to Finnair Plus at the same time with these changes.
So this is all the strategy for being profitable again. In what year do you expect to be profitable again as Finnair?
So it's correct. We are aiming at restoring the profitability that we had pre-pandemic. And not all the changes that we introduce, not all the renewals are directly driving profitability, but many are.
Will be there a chance? I mean, you can buy luggage, extra luggage. You can buy it, of course, as an insider tip, buy it when you buy the ticket, because then it's the cheapest. At the airport, it's more expensive.
Makes sense.
For a reason.
Makes sense.
Of course, makes sense. But is there a way to get more hand luggage? As a lot of people are trying to avoid checked-in luggage, even they have it free because of their status as benefit. Sometimes at the airport where you wait, I did wait 50 minutes in Frankfurt for my luggage. So is there a way that I can buy a third piece of hand luggage? Is this thought about?
The problem here is the limited space in cabin, and therefore it's not possible to buy extra cabin baggage. Of course, then if there's a medical device that's needed on board, that's a different case. Then it's possible to contact our customer service and get that into cabin. But due to the limited space, it's not possible to buy extra carry-on bag to cabin.
I saw it, for example, that somebody who is a musician, he can buy the seat next to him to strap his cello or whatever crazy machine he is playing with. So that would be a way as well. You could do it.
That's an option.
Then we have, of course, the question of the points value. As the points you are now needing in the new points system are getting more for the flights from, for example, to the US, which increased from 80 to 95,000 points one way, and the copay increased as well. Does it mean that the points will have less value? Because when you buy them, for example, you can buy the Finnair points?
So true. We introduced a new pricing for classic award flights and travel class upgrades, and those changes go into effect on June 15th this year. We have not changed the points pricing of many other services that we offer. So it's not that straightforward. But for these two categories, if you like, the price changes will go into effect now.
And when it comes to the points, a lot of people buy tickets on points, or they just upgrade with points. Why does this not count towards your tier points? That you, for example, when you fly business class on my US ticket I just mentioned for the now soon 95,000 points one way, why don't you get points for that as well, which counts for the tier?
I could agree. It's a nice extra benefit if you get awarded on awards. That's a good idea. That's an interesting idea. So far, we have chosen not to implement that into Finnair Plus program.
But at least the segment could count because hotels. So maybe one idea from my side: if you fly for free, it counts as a segment. Maybe that would be a nice way where we meet in the middle.
Extra.
No points.
Maybe I could just share. I'm not sure if everybody is aware, but in Finnair Plus program, you can earn tier points, or you can collect flights, and that's the way to gain status in the program, to move to higher tiers. So those are the two mechanisms that you refer to.
For the Finnish customers, of course, we have now a very nice feature, the 450 points you give monthly, I think, on the Aktia credit card, or is it on all credit cards?
So with Finnair Visa that is issued by Aktia Bank in Finland, and it's a card that is available for Finnair Plus members in Finland, we award points for the use of credit card. And now, starting from June, we also award tier points, 450 tier points, if a member uses the card for 1,500 euros per month worth.
Oh, nice. And is there any idea to give my German viewers, for example, the availability of a German Finnair credit card if they want to collect miles, that they maybe get away from a, let's call it competition, or somebody who's accompanying you in the market?
That's absolutely a fantastic idea. Let's see if that would happen one day. With Finnair Visa credit card, it's also some other benefits that I just wanted to share. If you have the card, you can now, starting from June, also transfer award points without a fee on Finnair Shop to other Finnair Plus members, and you can exchange your award points to tier points once during the tracking period without any fee.
How many points is the maximum that I can transfer from award points to tier points?
So that is maximum half of required tier points.
For Lumo, you need 450,000 points, so you could 225,000 points transfer
to tier points.
That would work.
Yeah.
Is there a difference if somebody is doing it? Do you see any difference for the people, how they got the Platinum, for example, or the Lumo card, if they transfer it or not? It's the same benefits. There's no difference for you as a customer.
No, so there are limits in place, and there's a conversion from award points to tier points. 3 award points convert to 1 tier point, and then there are restrictions.
But the question is more, is there a difference? So it's not a customer who just changed 50% of the points. He's a Platinum second class, first class. Nobody knows it even.
I mean, it's not communicated to. We know it, we will not share it, but it's not relevant.
It's a secret, sneaky way to get the status, and nobody will know. That is a good thing, because if you are short of it, and the Platinum status, in my opinion, is a very valuable status already in Finnair, that is a good thing. Then the other question is, of course, the award flights. We talked about it. The availabilities are at least challenging for some destinations. I was looking for a friend for going to Singapore, and Singapore is a destination which is, of course, a high-yield market. A lot of people want to fly there, they pay. Is there something that you think about to extend the period for the old mileage accounts, or you just say 15 is the hard cut, sorry?
Well, this is a topic of great interest, award flights and upgrades. And it's of course a balancing act. So we as an airline, we want to sell seats to premium economy and business class, as well to economy class. And then we want to award our members with the possibility to buy award flights with the points that they have earned, or upgrade to higher cabin class. If we look at the data and our network, we have every day more seats available for award flights than we have demand. But then again, the demand and supply, they don't always meet, right? So some routes are more popular than the others. And as I just very recently looked into availability this coming autumn, I think on a typical day in autumn, we have more than 2,000 seats available for award flights in one of our travel classes. So there's availability. I do acknowledge, though, that the supply and demand, they don't always meet. We are going to do the change on 15th of June.
So the takeaway is just, you're looking for the wrong destination. Maybe you should be flexible and then not fly to Singapore, look for another destination where you find the mileage, of course.
Well, that would be an option.
Then another question which comes up when you go and upgrade, for example, now people are having tickets where they say, I want to be waitlisted. And the ticket is in the future. And what happens if the waitlist is accepted after the 15th of June? Do I get the old points, the old copay? Do I get the new copay? How does this work?
So let's start with the travel class upgrades. So if you waitlist an upgrade before June 15th, and you are on the waitlist, and then it gets confirmed after June 15th, for travel class upgrades, the old prices will apply. Then for award flights, if you do the same, you waitlist before June 15th, and then you get confirmed after June 15th or on June 15th, you will get the award flight with the old points prices. However, there will be a surcharge, and the surcharge is from 10 euros to 140 euros, depending on the journey.
And what happens if I want to change the date? As a platinum feature, which I liked very much, is that I can change the date of a ticket as long as it's availability and it's not more than 1 year when the ticket was issued. Is this still a benefit we get as Platinum Lumo members, or is it something which we will be changing as well, that we have to pay the 50 euros fee when you cancel your ticket?
It's correct that this is one of the extra benefits that we've chosen to give to our Gold, Platinum and Lumo members, that if you book an Avard flight, you can change it without a fee on the same route also now.
And there is a magic 37 hours. What is the reason for the 37 hours when it gets confirmed and not confirmed? Is it a technical reason behind it? What is the idea behind it?
No, that's also a good question. So 37 hours relates to our check-in that opens 36 hours before the departure. So by clearing and confirming waitlisted upgrade or avoid requests before check-in opens, we want to give an opportunity for those customers who don't get upgrade or avoid flight in higher cabin class confirmed, a possibility to still buy some travel extras, pre-book a meal, for example, for the flight.
And one thing is, of course, when you did not accept it for your wait list, unfortunately, you are flying premium economy and you wanted to go into business class. And you enter the plane and there are still empty business class seats. Why can the people not be upgraded then? What is the reason behind that?
Right. So maybe starting from the fact that we never want to leave empty seats into our planes. We don't want to leave empty seats to business class, premium economy or economy. Of course, there are many reasons why a seat may be empty when you enter an aircraft and you see empty seats in business class. Maybe good example would be that the customer who was supposed to sit on that seat simply lost the connection and couldn't make it. And in these cases, we don't always have operational capability to offer that upgrade with such a short notice.
Sometimes we hear as a reason as well that we cannot get the upgrade at the gate because there's nothing catered. So is this a reason as well that you, because of lack of catering, cannot get the seat, that you don't get the full meal?
That could be a reason. It can be that the seat is not functioning as it should. There could be many reasons, but correct.
So sometimes it's better not to get the seat, even you sitting in premium economy, which is pretty good as well, in my opinion, because the other seat is unfortunately, that is true. Then a question which comes very often, especially in the Facebook forum, and that is when people offer to sell their points, to sell the Gold card, which they get with their Platinum or with their Lumo, or they sell upgrades. Is this something which is allowed? Is this something where you say this is not allowed? How is the position of Finnair by selling the awards or the benefits you get as a customer?
Our position is that those benefits are personal and we would like to keep it like that. They are for the member who earned them or who got them from us.
So a big no-no for you, do not sell your benefits. That is not wanted. And I mean, for me as a Platinum, it doesn't matter, but for a lot of people who are Gold, if they are just sold, I think it devalues the status as well for those who have flown it honestly.
Yeah, I see your point.
That would be my egoistic point of view to say it. Because when I give the status away, for example, my Platinum status to my wife, that she is having the benefits when I'm not flying with her, but as I'm flying 90% with her, or even more, she would be anyways allowed in the lounge.
Correct.
And lounge is a topic which is challenging as well. We have now the change in catering, which is, for me, very good, because we have now the vegetarian options are gone. We have now meat, which is very nice, and it got, in my opinion, elevated. Is there a way where you think that you get more benefits for the Lumo members or the Platinum members, that they don't have to share, especially the Schengen lounge, because it's sometimes really crowded and you don't find space? Is there a way how you maybe can give them a better experience in the lounge?
No, we continue developing the program. We evolve our offering, but I don't have any news to share on that. So, So it's actually take the idea. Well, you refer probably to the model that we have in at Helsinki Airport in our non-Schengen area where we have a Platinum Wing and Business Lounge.
Yeah, because a lot of airlines differentiate between their statuses and that you have at least a little seat. I had the challenge to find a seat when I was coming during the rush hour, but I still had space, so it was just that it was crowded. It's whining on a high level, of course. I mean, it's...
No, but lounge is an important service, and we are interested definitely how our members feel about it.
Mm. When it comes to the promotions, we used to have the 100% promotion during COVID, where we had the one time where you could even get a status with buying points. Finnair is getting 100 years old, and I think I just saw somewhere the A350 with the 100 years together since 1923. Right. Is there coming some promotion? The people are asking, as you can buy only once a year points.
So let me just start a little bit from the history. We are turning 100 years this year. We are proud of our history. We have our eyes on the future. We are celebrating 100 years with long-haul aircraft liveries, with Moomins, as you saw. We at the moment do have an exhibition of flight attendant uniforms at Helsinki Airport. And we have been having campaigns, and we are going to have campaigns. You might guess that I'm not going to share in advance how those will be, but let's see. Let's see how the year continues.
I had to ask the question.
Of course.
I would have been slapped by the people if I don't ask it. And as we are already over the time, and I'm really grateful that you take the time to talk to us, what is the reason why people should collect with Finnair Plus? What would be your points to give the people?
Well, with Finnair Plus, when you join the program, your tracking period starts right away. So you have 12 months time to earn points, earn your status, move forward in the program, get to enjoy the offers, get to enjoy the promotions that we offer with our partners. And once you move to higher tiers, you get to enjoy the benefits that we and our One World partners offer to you when you travel.
So join Finnair Plus, be a member, and get the benefits from the program. Thank you, Pekka Antila, that you took the time for the interview. I know that you have a very packed day today, that you are busy as you just pop in and pop out. Thank you so much, and maybe we can do it another time again and have some blueberry juice.
That would be a pleasure. And thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lars.
This was the interview with Finnair Plus, Pekka Antila. Thank you for your time. I hope you had all answers to your questions. If you have any questions which were not answered, or if you have any clarification needs, do not hesitate to write under the show notes into the comments, and I'm more than happy to come back to you. But so far, thank you to you for watching this show, and thank you, of course, Finnair, to hosting us and staying for our answers very calm, because some were not easy in my opinion.